This screencast considers transient conduction, in particular, the method called lump capacitance. What happens if the boundary conditions change with time and for an object? Other parameters do as well. And an example is a solid whose thermal environment changes suddenly. And whenever you see the word suddenly, that should immediately alert you to the fact that this is a transient problem. What will happen is that T, which originally had only been a function of X or Y or Z or R, is now a function of time. So the easiest way to analyze this is to assume, if we're looking at a solid, that the temperature in the solid is spatially uniform at any time. So what does that mean? That doesn't mean that it never changes. What it means is, for example, if you have at time equals zero, the temperature in the solid is 300 K, then at time equals 500 seconds, the temperature is 200 K, and this is the temperature throughout the solid. So one of the important things is that means there are negligible temperature gradients. Another thing that then assumes is that our thermal conductivity is infinite, which obviously can't be the case, but we can approximate this if the resistance to conduction within the solid is very much less than the resistance between the solid and the surroundings, which is convection. So in other words, what that means is L over K, where L is a characteristic length and K is our thermal conductivity, is very much less than 1 over H, where H is the convective heat transfer coefficient. So how can we tell that this is applicable? Well, we use what's known as the Biot number. This is a dimensionless parameter of the heat transfer coefficient times some characteristic length divided by the thermal conductivity. And what do you think? Should this number be small or large? The answer is it should be small, because L over K needs to be small. Take a look at our conductive resistance, and 1 over H needs to be large. And for that to happen, the number has to be small. And in fact, we can assume this analysis that we call lumped capacitance if the Biot number is less than 0.1. Our overall energy balance simplifies to the energy rate out equals the stored energy. In other words, our convective energy, which is T minus T infinity, equals rho times V times C, the change in temperature with respect to time. So first let's look at this rho VC. So rho is the density of the solid, V is the volume of the solid, and C is the heat capacity. This is also known as the lumped thermal capacitance of the solid. And as this expression increases, the solid will respond more slowly to any changes. So in our analysis, we introduce a theta, which is defined as T minus T infinity. And one of the things to notice is we are not saying T surface or anything like that. This is T at a certain time. So if we take the derivative of this, with respect to time, we find it's also dt dt. Now we can write the expression from above like this, and this is going to equal minus theta. Now we integrate both sides, separate and integrate. This goes from theta sub I to some theta d theta over theta is equal to minus from 0 to L, where L is our characteristic length, dt. And notice we have this theta sub I. This is defined as, instead of t, this is t initial minus t infinity. As you can see from our integral, that is at t equals 0. So let's solve this, and we find that rho vc over h a sub s ln of theta sub I over theta equals t. So this is the time it would take to go to some temperature based on this expression right here. So let's write this out in terms of a temperature. So T minus T infinity over Ti minus T infinity, this is going to equal the exponential of minus H times A sub S over rho times V times C all times the time. So these are two expressions that we can use, one if we're trying to find a particular temperature, and one if we're trying to find the time to get to a certain temperature. And just as a reminder, this is our heat transfer coefficient. So this comes from our convection. Our A is our surface area. Our big T is our temperature at some time. Our Ti is the temperature at time equals 0. And finally, our rho Vc is the lumped thermal capacitance of the solid.